Hey everybody, this is the final video of Skylanders Giants for 3DS. The final video of, I guess, the playthrough. I might have some bonus content later on, but anyway. This is Dragon's Peak, and the level is the Pit. And this is the challenge level of this world. We have 50 enemies to defeat, elemental match is fire. Avoid the dragon fire. Those are like the flamethrower torches from the previous level. They're in here too, and they're kind of everywhere. And don't eat food. So this one is probably going to be kind of challenging. But like I said, this is the last level, and I don't really have to do anything else after this. I mean, I might show off the hats at the end. I did say I was thinking about doing something like that. Okay, so 50 enemies to defeat, and I just got hit by a torch. That's great. I didn't think they'd be out in round one. Oh yeah, I kept Whirlwind from the previous video too. I think having these two would be pretty good, because Sunburn's kind of like a close-range character, if you notice, and then Whirlwind can shoot the rainbows and stuff like that, and the Tempest Clouds, so that'll be really helpful. A lot of the enemies here are from the previous level, and the enemies from there and here are pretty powerful, so trying my best to like stay alive here. I'm thinking maybe I wanted to use Sunburn for this one, because if you noticed, I use the characters that actually are packaged with the adventure packs in the challenge levels. I've done it for all of them. At first it was coincidence, but then after like the second or third time, it was like, yeah, I'm doing this one. I'm just gonna pick them, might as well. Anyway. The thing with Whirlwind I kind of forgot was that her defense and HP is pretty low. I was trying to teleport out of the way, but I almost teleported into some food. I'll make sure I get these coins as well. Okay, now, I think in this next round, which I believe is the final one, hopefully it is. There's more torches and stuff like that. You notice the big enemies are here too. To kill 50 enemies. That's probably easier if, maybe during the time challenge or something, I don't know. But right now it's kind of annoying, because I'm trying to avoid, like, the food. Have to take her out. Yeah, I wish Sunburn's flamethrower was like more long range. Like right now it doesn't really have much range. It's pretty powerful, especially when it's in the blue form, but you have to be like right in their face. But at least he kind of tracks his head, like he moves his head around when the enemies move around a little bit. That kind of helps. Sometimes you can lock them in place too, like I did with that witch. I'm nowhere near close to the enemy goal here. I still need 20 more. I've taken a lot of damage already. Okay, well, what did I do here? I did elemental match, obviously. Don't eat food. Okay, that's actually, that will make the enemy and dragon fire goals a little bit easier, because you can be a little bit more reckless. Well, except not running. You can't run into the dragon fire, but at least you can like fight the enemies without having to worry about getting hit and taking food. Okay, I'm gonna repeat that again, not in the time challenge, but just the regular version, because I think I could fight more enemies that way. Okay, so I think this time what I'm gonna do, I just kept the same too, I didn't really care. I could probably pull this off of these two, but what I'm gonna do here is try to take out, like, I don't have to go exactly 50 in round one, but what I'm gonna try to do is get you know, maybe like 30 or so. It's very easy because, like, this part has a lot of chompies. You know, they die in, like, a second, so that really helps out. Oh, you know what? Oh, crap. I should have been avoiding the coins. Let's see, if Whirlwind was upgraded a little bit, I could charge up the rainbow attack. It does a lot of damage. Okay, I think here I'm gonna try to get up to 30 or 40. This is way easier in the earlier rounds because, you know, you don't have to deal with the witches, stuff like that. Oh, wait, I can actually grab food now, too. Forgot about that. Power of rainbows. Yeah, I'm gonna try to get it to 40 here. Okay, these two are getting on my nerves. I thought I was about to stun lock him. Thankfully, there aren't a lot of torches active yet. There's only like a few, so I can actually wander off into some of these other areas. Okay, I should be avoiding these coins now. Yeah, if I can at least get up to 40, then I'll be okay. The only thing is, like, the middle part keeps spewing, like, the free coins. Oh, just like right now. Alright, well, this is the third part, and they're gonna summon the big ogre guys. If I can get rid of this one, then I should be okay for a little bit. There we go. Alright, just four more. I'm gonna start collecting coins, too. So I don't have to wait too long to go through the exit. There's the last enemy. I just have to collect these coins. And, like, the thing is, I have to still avoid the flamethrowers. I thought there were more than just... It seems like there's just two of them going off right now. I thought there were more, but maybe it was in the first game. There were more of them. Okay, almost there. I almost got hit into one of those torches. Alright, and we should be done. Just make sure. Yeah, defeat 50 enemies and avoid the dragfire. Alright, so that's it. Okay, and I almost forgot about the time challenge. Alright, so this is a time challenge. This one shouldn't be as bad because I don't have to like worry about the dragon fire or, you know, anything like that. Just have to defeat enemies and collect coins. More of an emphasis on collecting coins. Enemies are just kind of in the way. Okay, yeah. I was gonna say, there's no enemies around, so I think I met my goal, so. And the combination of enemies they chose for this level is, like, really, really frustrating. Like, the spear guys are really annoying, and they have a lot of HP, and then the Drow Witches, I think that's what they're called. They don't have a lot of HP, but they shoot off those energy waves, and the range on those is crazy. Like, they can hit you from, like, the other side of the arena. But this should be pretty easy for these two. I think this is a pretty good combination. I think his Fright Rider has, like, his defense isn't really the greatest. But that's why I brought Legendary Bouncer here. I didn't bring the regular Bouncer because he's already maxed out. He's level 15, so I didn't want to waste the experience points, basically. Alright, spear versus spear. There we go. Alright, and there goes that round. This last one, oh, I thought it was 150. I say it should be quick, but there's 180 to collect. Okay, now we have the big ogre guys to deal with. Oof, jeez, that did a lot of damage. I need to switch out. I need some food is what I need. Okay, there we go. That helped a little bit. Not much, but it was something. Those ogre guys are really dangerous. Shoot, I'm running out of time. Where are all the extra coins? Okay, oh man, I'm really running out of time here. Oh, I don't think I'm gonna make it. And this dude's farting in my face. Just to. Oh, and the fountain, the coin fountain went off at the very end. I think it's weird that Frightbeard shows up at the end even though he's been defeated and locked up. I guess that's just the standard game over screen. Alright, let's try this again. I think this time what I'm going to do is just really, really focus on getting the coins. The other thing is at the end, if you notice, like, they didn't really drop coins. Like, until, like, the very end, the fountain wasn't really spouting the coins, which is where you're going to get most of them from. You had to get them from the enemies. So a problem was that Fright Rider, his defense is kind of low, so I had to keep scrambling for food. And then Legendary Bouncer started running out of health too. He was taking a lot of hits from, like, the spear enemies and stuff like that. Oh, that didn't help. He moved out of the way. You two need to stop that. If you notice, some of the enemies, when they drop coins, it's not a lot. It's just like one coin. I guess every little bit helps, but it doesn't make things faster. Well, that much anyway. Alright. So I have a little over a minute and a half to finish the rest of these, this coin mission. It's pretty strict though, they don't really give you a lot of time. I guess that's why this one was last. Actually, you could do it in any order, but Dragon's Peak is supposed to be the last one, if you're going in order. Alright, need about 39 more. Shoot, I didn't mean to knock her off. You don't get a coin for doing that. Alright, I have less than a minute left. I really hope I make it. Okay, this coin fountain is really going to help out too. That's what happens when you run into the ogre's fart and like gasses up the screen. Oh shoot. I grabbed them when they're silver. I hopefully should be able to make it. Oh! Maybe you can just step on it to activate it. I thought it was activated like on its own. I just need one more coin. There we go. Ah, hurry up, hurry up! There we go. And we're done. That was actually kind of tough. It wasn't as bad. Empire Vice is by far the hardest challenge level. But I'd probably say that was second. Yeah, because Darklight Crypt wasn't that bad. It was kind of tough, but not like this. This one you really had to race against time. Alrighty, so that is the end of the game. We've gone through all the levels and collected everything. I do have a bonus video coming up that'll show some of the unlockables and some of the stuff that I didn't use in the game, and some characters that didn't show up in the playthrough as well. Alright, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you then.